In the previous videos, we simply set up our notification email alerts to go to our own individual contact email address. Now, I'll show you how you can set up other options and send to things like delivery endpoints, groups, and escalation teams. Keep in mind, to make these changes, you have to have permissions to do so on the AF server. Now, in the previous video, remember, I just took my individual contact email address and I dragged it in to make my email address the subscription. But how did notifications know what my email address is? This works because when notifications was installed, it imported information from Active Directory and automatically created individual contacts. And that's why it has my email here. I can also search for other contacts that have already been automatically created using the contacts search. So for example, I'm going to search for my colleague and notice how I can use the wildcard. And from there, I can go ahead and add her email on the subscriptions. This methodology works well if you are going to add some individual users and their contacts are already created, just like this. But if we want, we'll explore some other options that we can leverage. And this contacts information is coming from the contacts that have been set up on this server, and we can actually make changes to them if we go down to the contacts tab. So let's look at the contacts tab. Again, here's the individual user account, and this is because I'm running Pi System Explorer as that account. And below it, I see the email. My email that I just boxed, that counts as a delivery endpoint. And when you hear the word delivery endpoint, just remember it's a single entity to which a notification is sent. So you might be wondering, well, how is that different from the individual contact that's Camille Metzinger? Well, let's say that I had an alternate email address. We could set that up, and then my individual user would have two different delivery endpoints. And if I needed to do that, I could just right-click and do new delivery endpoint. And again, I can configure another email address and provide information saying this is an alternate email address. And I'll set that up as an example. And once I've set that up, I can go ahead and check this in. And you can see that now I have two delivery endpoints, both of which are emails for my individual contact. Each delivery endpoint actually has its own options for how many times to retry the notifications and at what interval, as well as what should be the from email or even if we should use HTML for the format. So these can be unique to different delivery endpoints. Now, we just created a delivery endpoint for an existing individual contact. But when would we create just a delivery endpoint that wasn't associated with a particular individual contact? This really makes sense if we were instead sending the notification to a web service. And a reason to do this is if the notification is actually kicking off some kind of workflow. Maybe to go ahead and order some new parts or do something like that. Now, in my case, I don't have a particular web service that I want to send notifications to, so I'm just going to actually go ahead and delete the delivery endpoint that I just started creating. Similarly, you can also right-click and create new contacts. This could be useful if there's somebody who is not part of your Active Directory who should be a contact and who should be receiving notifications, say maybe a partner. Now there's a couple other options we need to talk about, and one of those is groups. Looking at groups brings up the question, well, what about our Active Directory groups? When they get imported, what do they get imported as? and they actually get imported as individual contacts. And we could search for them just the same way that we search for my colleague, Kelsey. So groups are different from our Active Directory groups. These are groups within AF. And this might make sense if there's not an existing Active Directory group that would make sense for a particular collection of users that we want to send notifications to. Let's go ahead and set up a group, and I'll show you what that looks like. So I'll right-click and do New Group. And in this case, let's say that I am one of a couple individuals who is responsible for responding to downtime maintenance. And we're going to set up a lot of different notifications for that. So I'll go ahead and set up a group that will incorporate those individual contacts. So the first thing is to give it a name. And now that I've got that filled out, I'm going to go ahead and add subscribers. I'll click here to add a subscriber. And I want to set up this group so that I'm a member. And for my delivery endpoint, I'm actually going to use the first email. But you can see that now both options show up. And I'm going to go ahead and also add my colleague that we looked for earlier. Okay, so I'll go ahead and check this in. And now I have a group that I can leverage, and it will include these two email delivery endpoints, one for myself and one for Kelsey. Bringing your attention back when we were adding a subscriber, however, the creation of groups, that's not limited to just individual contacts. We could add delivery endpoints or escalation teams too, if we had those configured, or we can even add other groups in addition to everything else. So this can be very customized. And the resultant group might include delivery endpoints that are both email addresses and web services. Now, with the group, all the subscribers specified are going to be notified at the same time. But if we want to be notified in a specific order, that's something that we can actually do with escalation teams. So let me create a new escalation team and break that down for you. Again, right-click, new escalation team, and I'll go ahead, get us started with a name and description. Okay, and let me start actually first by adding the same subscribers that were in our group and showing you how this would be different from a group. Okay, so I've added the same delivery endpoints as was in our group, but now they have a specific order. And you can see I can use the arrows to move them up and down. With this order, when an event frame gets created, I will be notified first via this email address. And after a set escalation period, if I have not acknowledged the event frame and it's still active, then Kelsey would receive an email at this address. So let's set that escalation period that I just described to be 15 minutes. So I'll configure that here. And again, the event frame starts, I receive a notification. If I have not acknowledged it and the event frame is still open, 15 minutes later, Kelsey will receive an email. Now what happens if after another 15 minutes, Kelsey has not acknowledged the event frame and the event frame is still open? Well, that's what is specified here. We could, for example, repeat a set number of times. We could continue to repeat as long as the event frame is active and neither have acknowledged it. Or we could end the escalation. In this case, it's really important that one of us takes ownership and responds to this. So as long as it's active, we're going to repeat the escalation. Again, you can customize this however makes the best sense for your particular situation. And then we can go ahead and check this in. So now that we have created some escalation teams and groups, when we're configuring the subscriptions to our notifications, we'll see those options are now available here. And we could add them, and for each individual delivery endpoint, we can still customize the configuration and whether or not they should receive a notification at the start or at the start and end. With that, we now have a variety of options to use to customize our notification subscriptions.